Go ahead.
First off, you stand by there, resecure the patient. We're gonna need towels, blankets, something like that, warm spot.
you about what happened.
Oh, she was a rescue yesterday and she just scooted out. That's all.
Wait, like scooted out of your house just north of the police station?
Yes.
And then you've been looking for her ever since yesterday?
Yeah, and as soon as I put it on Facebook, the community just went insane to help me. Wow, just quite the community. Wonderful.
What do you think about these firefighters?
Oh, amazing, and law enforcement, and now... And Lisa is from one of the primary rescue groups here, and has just kept me going.
Beautiful.
She worked all day and was texting me all day.
Did you ever think you'd have a happy ending?
Yeah, I do, because Lisa kept me going.
What it's about.
Yeah.
Nigel, I guess it was a long way out. How was it walking out, and what was the dog like?
It's a bit of a rough walk. You know, as you see, the boulders are kind of on just whatever angle they fell. So it was a tiring walk to get out there. The dog, when we got out, he got scared and went down into the water, which is a bit concerning. He was getting pretty cold, but we managed to sneak under some rocks, and I scared him one way. My partner was able to grab him, and we got him out and back home.
Pretty concerning when he sort of was in the water, just because under the boulders you don't know where it's going.
Yeah, we couldn't see him for a little bit. We knew he was down there, and we knew he was having a tough time staying above the water. He's just a little guy, so he was getting cold. So we had to move kind of fast, but we managed to grab a hold of him.
Did you know once you had him, was he comfortable around you, or was he still skittish?
Yeah, he quieted up for us. He was pretty cold when we got him. He was shivering pretty hard, but he was good the whole way back. He didn't fight us at all, so that's a bonus. First time.